Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Divi's Kitchen. So today we are going to be making a very delicious and awesome recipe. This is one of my mom's favorite to accompany with all of the delicious dishes that we make. We are going to be making naan. So this is a very simple recipe. It takes a bit of time, but that is only due to the fact that the dough has to rise for like 2.5 hours. But other than that, it is a very quick recipe. And in the video, you will see me using like a blue pan, and it is a bit blackened. So don't you guys worry. When you're making such flatbreads and you're baking it on a stove, the pans tend to reach a high temperature, and that's why they tend to blacken. So those pans are kept separate only for those purposes. So without further ado, let's get cooking. So we are going to begin by taking 1/2 cup of warm water, to which we will add 1 tablespoon of active dry yeast. Next goes in 1 teaspoon of sugar, which will act as food for the yeast. Mix it up and let it bloom for 10 to 15 minutes. Next, we are going to take 500 grams of maida, add in a pinch of salt, and add 1 cup of yogurt, followed by our yeast mixture. Next, using a wooden spatula, we are going to mix this all together and start forming our dough. You are going to mix it all together till your dough is roughly combined, and then you are going to go in with your hands and make sure it is nicely incorporated and the dough starts forming and it comes together. In this recipe, you want to make sure that you use the least amount of liquid as possible. Try to make your dough within the amount of yogurt and yeast mixture itself, but if needed, you can use a little bit of water. So you're just going to mix it all together very nicely. And you can see after some time it starts forming into a more manageable dough. At first it will seem to be very sticky, and it will be not very easy to work with. That is why we are using the spatula. It just sort of gets things going, and then you can knead it with your hand. At this point, when your dough starts to come together, you want to make sure that you don't add in extra water, because it will be very difficult to sort of salvage the dough from here, because you'll have to keep adding in more dry flour, and that can mess with your yeast proportions. And you're going to keep on kneading this until like all of the dry flour is nicely incorporated into the dough, and it is nice and soft, like so. At this point, you will see that the dough is very sticky. So you're just going to take it out on a flat surface, like I have done onto this tray. And after 5 to 6 minutes of kneading this on the tray, you're going to put it in a bowl, cover it with plastic wrap or aluminium foil, and you're going to let it rest for 2 to 2.5 hours. So after 2.5 hours, you can see it has rose very nicely, and it is very squishy and looks really nice. You can see all the gluten that is formed there. And you can see how the yeast has respired and produced all of this air in the dough. So we are going to begin by taking a ball of dough and flattening it out, and then we are going to oil our surface, spread that around, and then put some oil on the top of the ball of dough, and we're going to start pressing from the middle to the outwards till it is in a elongated shape, and it is about 1/4 of an inch thick. Next, we're going to take in 1/4 teaspoon of kolanji seeds and press it in. Then you're going to flip it in your hands, and at the bottom apply some water. Next, you're going to move on to your pan, which is at a medium to high heat, and you're gonna cover with a lid. So after some time, you'll see that the lid is fogged with the steam, and that's the time you want to flip your naan, and you can see it has turned nice and brown at the bottom. And you're just going to sort of cook it on both sides till it's done. And once it's done, you're just going to take it off the stove and make the rest of the dough just like this. So guys, here we have all our naans and we have some melted butter. So we're going to just brush it on there, and these are done. So you can see how delicious these naans look and go perfect with any dish. You can have it with butter chicken, butter paneer, anything you like. So do try this recipe. Bye.